Thank you for tuning in to Big City Chronicles. Surge here with the very talented Bryan Michael Stoller. How are you doing today, Bryan?
I'm good, thank you.
Yep. Well, Bryan, I understand that you are not only the owner of Little Bear, but you are the writer, producer, and director of his movies. Is that correct?
That is correct, yeah.
Wow, so you took care of your one-man show, notwithstanding Little Bear, for both the Amazing Wizard of Paws and First Dog.
Yeah, actually, Little Bear is the one who inspired the movies. Because I'm an independent filmmaker, he inspired them, so I wrote the films for him.
Wow, how did he inspire you? Tell us a little bit more about that.
Well, I've had Bear since he was about 3 weeks old. And he was actually, about a month after I adopted him, I found out that he was fostered by Nancy Reagan. Mm-hmm. He was rescued by the Reagans. And that told me right there, well, gee, he was kind of a former first dog. And so that's why I wrote for him as a first dog in the movie First Dog. And he was pretty much auditioning for me all those years that I've owned him. And so I knew what he was capable of and saw that he was a very smart actor.
You know, this is the first time I've ever interviewed an animal. Have you been interviewed by a superhero before? You know, I've also been kind of thinking about, I may need a sidekick, sort of a mascot. Maybe Surge needs a super dog. Would you be interested in working with a superhero in a movie sometime? I think I can imagine you being a cape. I think you would put Crypto and Ace the Bat Hound to shame. You would be better than Underdog. I see you have you're kind of dressed up to display both of your movies: the glasses for The Wizard of Paws and your very patriotic tie for First Dog. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, well, me too. That's why when I do interviews, they want me to be like in full like Surge regalia. It's important to keep promoting yourself. Uh-oh. Have the fans been wearing you out, Little Bear? Did you get into filmmaking because of Little Bear, or were you doing other work as well?
I've been making films since I was about 9 years old, and I'm originally from Canada, and I had a TV show called Film Fun when I was 12, showing kids how to make their own movies. This was in Canada, and then I was accepted at the American Film Institute, so that's what brought me out here. So I've been an independent filmmaker for a long time.
Yeah. Wow, that's fantastic. And then, so obviously, then you're sort of stepping it up a notch with movies like The Amazing Wizard of Paws and First Dog.
Yeah, I can only make movies that inspire me and that I'm passionate about, and I'm very passionate about Bear. He's my little furry child, the love of my life, and so I wanted to, you know, show off his talents and at the same time make a great, you know, bunch of dog movies, and, you know, families really take to them, so.
I can imagine. You know, I remember when I was a kid, you know, Benji, you know, that was a sort of big thing back then. You know, do you remember Benji?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Bear was a fan of Benji's, and he said he wanted to get into the business because he was inspired by Benji.
Oh, okay. Lassie, too? Is he too young to know Lassie?
He's a little too young to know Lassie, but he sort of knows who Lassie is, yeah.
But on Nick at Night or, you know, Boomerang, he gets to see reruns.
Sometimes. The thing with the difference between Benji and Lassie, especially Lassie, they used a lot of doubles. The thing with Bear, because he's such a unique-looking dog, he's a Kaikan, which is a rare Japanese dog. And because he's so talented and good with expressions, there's no double for Bear. So every scene in the movie is Bear, whether it's an action scene, a stunt, or just, you know, reactions and things.
Keep an eye out for First Dog Second Term. And thank you again, Bryan Michael Stoller, for joining us on Big City Chronicles.
Tune in
again. And until then,
make a difference
where you can.